Hey everybody, I want to introduce to you my 2025 art project, Frame. For 15 years, I've been doing open frame case concepts. It started with the NFC Arc, which combined multiple components, sweeping lines, and a great display of their graphics card. I really like this concept, but it never really was a good daily driver. It never was a computer that I was proud to use and own, for multiple reasons. The first thing is, it's really difficult to access the I.O. It's pointed straight down, so you kind of have to get below the desk and look up to plug things in, and it was kind of a pain to plug things in. The second thing is, where do the cables go? Yeah, sure, the build looks really nicely on the table without any cables plugged in, but once you start plugging your I.O. in your graphics card, it's a mess. Oh man, power supply, it's always the biggest challenge in any PC mod. How do you make it look good? And I just never really found a solution, although I got close with some iterations. Then I saw this graphics card. It's the 9070 XT by Sapphire. It's a Nitro Plus model, and I fell in love with it as soon as I saw the pre-release renders. And if you like, you can check out a video I made for Sapphire on their channel going over the beautiful details of this graphics card. It was the kind of graphics card that made me know that I wanted to pursue updating my open case design, and I think I finally have a variant that checks all of my boxes after 15 years. So addressing the first problem, and that's what do you do with all the I.O. cables? Well, two things in this instance. I tilted the entire build back slightly, 20 degrees at first, and then I kept tweaking it from there, and now it's at a 7-degree angle. This allows you to easily access, see your ports, plug everything in. But then, what about the cables? They're still pointing down and making a rat's nest on your desk. Well, the solution for that was actually pretty simple as well. I made a channel that everything can be routed into. After several prototypes of trying to actually fit them in there and plug everything in, which kind of a pain in the butt, I finally have the perfect spacing, I think, for using right-angle cables or adapters. So that's one problem solved, but the other problem is, what do you do with the power supply? And I really love how this is shaping up. So the power supply isn't below the motherboard, it's not behind the motherboard even, it's actually embedded kind of in the motherboard. Now, of course, that doesn't make any sense without the case, but that's what the case makes it feel like. So it doesn't stick out like a big, ugly, giant box, but it still has just enough exposure to really sell this whole open case design that really frames your components. And that's why I call it the NFC frame. So the power supply ports are facing upward, so you can have super neat, tight, clean runs of cables with custom work, of course. Something else that I really love about this graphics card, the 9070 XT Nitro Plus, is that the power cable actually comes in from behind the graphics card and it's covered by a plate. This is going to make routing the cable super clean instead of bringing it around the front and wrapping it along the side. How do you access the power supply's AC cable? Pretty easily, actually. It took a couple of tries to kind of figure out the best method. So what you do now is simply you bolt a bracket to the power supply, install it first, and then you can install the motherboard over it. So kind of a neat, simple solution that allows you to have access to everything. And yes, you can flip the toggle switch to power it on, turn it off, plug the cable in. One of the things I really love about this mod and how it's shaping up is how balanced and stout it is. You plop this on the table, it's not going anywhere. It's very heavy, of course, but just so compact and firm. It feels excellent, even though that this is just a prototype. Unfortunately, I'm a big giant idiot, and to frame the build right in the video, I put it on this box. And I have my arm on the table, so I'm just now noticing it's been flopping around the whole time, but it's actually extraordinarily stout. And right now, too, they're on rubber bumper feet, but when I touch this, I move the whole table. It's stout. For the graphics card, at first I made a two-slot variant because the beautiful NVIDIA Founders Edition cards are two slots, and even the huge Asus Astral only has a two-slot bracket, but a lot of these oversized cards, which we want to really show off, are three-slot. Now, instead of making the case huge to accommodate it, which I did try, just didn't look good, I opted for a really simple solution, and that was simply to notch the side of the case to allow the PCI bracket to stick through. That way, I still get to have my cake and eat it too. It's a skinny product. It still fits on my 3D printer like the Bamboo X1C, and you can fit oversized graphics cards, as many as you want if they ever made like a 4-slot one. First prototype stand I made was a U-shape. This is kind of problematic because it means that it can't be bent on a normal press break, even a CNC press break, because, well, it's going to bend over and hit the die. So I had to bend it on my electromagnetic break, which excels at that kind of work. But at 5 millimeters thick, it's a little difficult to bend. It's also a very expensive part, being it's a huge solid piece. I think instead I'm going to be doing it like I did for my second prototype, where I split it into two different components. Now, looking at this case at the bottom, you might say, oh, this looks pretty unfinished. And that's because it is. I'm experimenting with how I exactly want to do the base. I left enough room so I could stick in a radiator, like a dual 92mm radiator, deep radiator, or, I mean, I don't know, there's a lot of things I could do. One of the things I'm looking at doing is putting a USB dock underneath because, well, with these builds, I'm always needing more ports, and this would give me super easy access. I could hide it in a little custom printed box, or even do a nice, beautiful wooden base. Really, that's kind of why I'm showing you this now. I want feedback. What are your ideas for this? And guess what? You can go download this on my Patreon, make one yourself, tweak it, and then post your feedback and updates. Let's work together to make this a really sick case. Speaking of working together, that's something I'm really excited about. Because it's just so open, so easy, you can even access things like the screws on the side to make accessories like mounts for a reservoir, for instance, or maybe even mount one of your radiators onto the side. One of the things that I did is I made brackets, alternate brackets, so I could mount it to the back of my TV. So when this is done, if I don't want it on my desk as a beautiful art piece, I can just slap it behind my TV and play my video games that way. Now, you'll notice that this is kind of a lazier video than ones I've made in the past, and I kind of want to address that really quickly. So, a small fraction of a percentage of the mods I do like this end up on YouTube, or even on the Discord or my Instagram. And that's because, well, one, I make a lot of stuff, but two, my standards have been raising higher and higher and higher as the channel has grown. And I can't just keep trying to make cinema pieces every single time that I make a video. That's not why I started this channel years and years ago to begin with. I just want to make cool stuff and share it with you guys so you can make cool stuff. When Eric came on, he kind of accelerated the whole panic of trying to outdo myself every time cinematographically with his beautiful work, but you know, even he got burnt out pretty quickly. So I just want to ask your patience and allow me to split up giant projects like this into bite-sized, kind of lazy overview ways like I'm doing right now so I can actually share them with you, because if not, I wouldn't have time to do this with my YouTube schedule. So again, I want to thank you guys very much. Please check out the Patreon to download these files. And, well, I'm going to see you actually really soon because you give me the freedom to make content that's simple to do like this. Actually, next week when I talk about the Minis Forum BD790i, which is absolutely phenomenal for small form factor builds. Maybe not this one exactly, because this could support much, much higher TDB CPUs, but for small form factor builds, check it out. All right, peace.